Good Thursday evening, everybody. Meteorologist Griffin already here with an update on our forecast. Keeping a close eye on Saturday's storm, which is going to bring possibly some really significant freezing rain amounts up to western North Carolina Saturday morning. We're dry for the moment with high pressure in control, but again, Saturday morning is when we are expecting some potential impacts from a winter storm, which is already producing some snow showers up towards New Mexico, Colorado, and some rain out ahead of it in Texas and Oklahoma. A winter storm watch in effect from tomorrow night into Saturday afternoon for heavy mixed precipitation. That means a mixture of snow, sleet, and freezing rain. The ice amounts of around 1/10 of an inch to 3/10 of an inch, those might be a little conservative. We've got some more model data that suggests the potential freezing rain amounts could be really high from 4 a.m. to 10 a.m. is when I expect the road conditions to be at their worst. I'm still expecting the road conditions to improve by Saturday afternoon once temperatures warm back up to the 40s, but we've got some potentially significant freezing rain amounts on the way. It stays quiet into tomorrow morning. Very cold start Friday. We'll wake up to mostly sunshine and temperatures in the low to mid 20s across most of the area. Clouds gradually begin to fill in by late morning, and we see mostly cloudy skies for the rest of the day tomorrow. And then really late tomorrow night and early Saturday morning is when a lot of this activity should start to come in. Here's midnight. You see it starting to come in around 1 a.m. with a mixture of snow showers, freezing rain, and sleet. The good news for the upstate is we're still expecting mostly just a cold rain because temperatures are just going to be maybe just a few degrees too warm for any mixture of freezing rain. But up towards Henderson County, up towards McDowell County, the freezing rain will be pretty long lasting. It'll go from 1 a.m. to 4 a.m. and then continue most likely at times until around 7, 8 o'clock in the morning. We'll see another wave of it come in at around 9 a.m. Still looking at mostly just a cold rain aside from just a few northern isolated counties in the upstate towards Greenville and Spartanburg counties right near the state line. Maybe some light ice accumulations to the north of I-85, way off to the north, actually close to the state line, like I said. But then the good news is by noon, a lot of the moisture moves out of here, and then we see a lot of the frozen precipitation move out of here as well. Temperatures moving above freezing in the mountains in the afternoon. That means road conditions should improve quite a bit heading into Saturday afternoon. But let's take a look at these potential ice amounts because they are really high with this latest high res model that we have coming in. 1/2 inch to 3/4 of an inch of ice potentially is what's being shown by our latest high res models. That is a ton of ice. Now, I'm not quite sure if this is showing a mixture of sleet and freezing rain, but if it is, that's good. But just goes to show you that we are really expecting some hazardous travel conditions towards Transylvania and Henderson counties in particular. Here's a closer view of it. Icy roads, very likely. I've updated the color palette to kind of highlight the impacts a little bit better. Those yellows showing lighter amounts, less than 1/10 of an inch. And then as you move up the scale towards those reds and those purples, that's around 1/2 inch to 3/4 of an inch of ice. Those amounts could be especially high in Transylvania County and Henderson counties. That's where you want to avoid traveling heading into Saturday morning for sure. And again, most of this should be melting by the time we get to noon Saturday and into the afternoon. The road conditions should look a lot better, but again, potentially very significant freezing rain moving into western North Carolina Saturday morning. The snow amounts do look pretty light as well because it'll be just heavy mixed precipitation. Only really one little isolated pocket there of southern Haywood County where we could get around 1 to maybe 3 inches of snow. The rest of the snow amounts do look on the lighter side heading into Saturday morning. So that's the latest on that. For the 4-day for the upstate, it looks like just cold rain is what we'll see with most of this activity clearing out by the time it gets to Saturday afternoon. Then it's quiet for the rest of the weekend, much quieter by comparison, mostly sunny for Sunday, mostly cloudy on Monday. We'll see another round of heavy rain move in Tuesday, Wednesday with another pretty strong storm system. Obviously, we got to get past Saturday morning. Once we do that, we'll focus our attention more on next Tuesday. Now, again, we'll keep you posted minute by minute as these model runs come in because we have some potentially very icy conditions setting up for Saturday morning for the mountains, possibly some lingering flurries Sunday morning, but not nearly as impactful as what could be on the way for Saturday morning. And again, another round of possible heavy rain moving in next Tuesday. We'll keep you posted on that once we get past Saturday. Have a great rest of your Thursday night, everybody.